A semi hauling a loaded cargo container, or C-can, flipped on its side.
Okay, here we go. It's a 40-foot C-can with a load of cases of whiskey inside. We'd like to try to drink our way to the bottom, but we don't think they will allow it. You're on the truck, please.
Yep. Digging down, eh?
Yep. There we go. She's loose.
Okay.
I got it to move. George, get over here.
Over there?
Let's see what we got here, buddy.
Once that pressure was off, we can release the lock.
Screw you, storage can. I win. I think we got lucky. It's as fast as it was. It could have been a little while longer.
Now that the semi and the container are separated, Eric plans to flip them upright, starting with the tractor trailer.
I'm just going to strong arm it over. You're going to do the same thing there.
Eric will pull on the front of the tractor while George pulls on the back end. They need to work in sync. And George has never been lead operator on a rotator.
Although he's new, he does take some guidance well.
I need a 3/8 chain and a half. Hey, I'll take that. I'll take an actual sister hook with two hooks.
If he does start to question, he's a smart enough guy that he's going to stop and ask for some guidance.
Once mine gets a little bit of a lead, I'll just let you know when, and then just start to follow, and I'll just follow with you, okay?
Okay.
Help! Stay on the ball!
I do have a remote, and I could walk right over to him.
He has a little remote. I have the controls on the truck. I don't have that fancy remote.
Take it over.
It's all you, George.
It's all me.
It's what I call sexy. He's gonna pull now. You watch yourself. Okay, we're gonna pull this out of the way, just leave it up on the shoulder. Then we're gonna back up both trucks so that one's on the either side of the container, and we're gonna slide it up into this lane, right between the two tow trucks.
With traffic moving fast in the open lane, Eric needs to get off the highway quick.
This is the 401, everybody's in a hurry.
He calls in extra backup to help wrestle the loaded 42,000 pound container out of the ditch.
He's just gonna go right there.
The 401, everything is quick. Everybody's in a hurry, and nobody wants to give you any room.
We're gonna pick up that container and put it up on the road now. Okay, let's get your legs down. Let's go, we're gonna get them legs down. The weight in the can is, they told me exactly 42,250 pounds. There could be an issue with the load shifting. That's going to be our biggest concern. It could all be smashed in the front of that can, and we're really trying to predict for sure where the weight is. We don't know where the load has ended up, who's going to have the biggest lift until we get it in the air. Okay, like that?
Yeah.
Beautiful. You guys ready? Make sure everybody's safe.
Yeah.
They'll use the two rotators, one on each end, to bring the can up to the road, where they'll roll it in midair.
George, boom it up if you have to.
Boom up?
Yeah, you gotta get it out of this mud. You're gonna like quadruple the weight by leaving all that mud there, right?
I don't wanna let him down for sure. It's just like putting your pride in your pocket.
Start getting that boom over the top of that corner, buddy. Keep that boom over top. There you go. Then you start letting out the right and taking the left.
Take some more of that bottom.
Take some more of the bottom?
The bottom, yeah. Okay, now boom up a hair. There you go. You got this, George.
I do.
You can? Let's get it between us now.
Boom out. Slide your boom back.
I can't believe I'm doing this. Like a year and a half ago, I would have never fathomed running a 40-ton sliding rotator, let alone barrel rolling a C-can of 43,000 pounds with it.
It'll be a complicated maneuver for a rookie operator, lifting with one winch while using a second to pull from the bottom.
Are you comfortable with that space?
Yeah, I'm fine with it.
George hasn't done a barrel roll yet, let alone with the rotator, so I'm trying to keep an eye on the truck that I'm operating as well as keep an eye on George.
George will have to ease off on the lift as he applies more pull.
Slide back.
And he'll have to match Eric's pace on the other end.
Okay, it's gonna be all about this one out, and that one you're gonna use at the same time just enough that this doesn't touch the ground. You got him, I got you.
Yeah.
You're on him.
Oh, we got leakage.
Smell the whiskey.
Okay, dude, down.
No, he's got to pull that side.
Booming over?
No, just pull.
If you let one winch line out too fast, the whole load could shift. It could just keep rolling and roll right back over.
Boom, down and in. Come on, get her down. Pull. Okay.
You're good now.
Yep. Bring it up, whole thing up.
Now we're gonna back one of our floats in and then rotate it out between the two wreckers and allow the float to back under it.
George, I'm gonna start bringing my end over.
And he needs George to line up his end the same way.
Boom up and out. Get him really close to the deck. I don't know if I'm gonna reach it. I want you guys to try and get over top of that thing nice and low. Just get it over the deck easy. Once he's over the deck, I'll be braver.
So for me, it's really difficult not to want to just walk over and grab the controls.
Put yours down. Push it to me. I'm going to go over there and do it for him in a minute.
But at that point, he wouldn't learn. And you've got to be able to count on a guy like Jordan. He's got to be able to learn.
No. You going to get it over or what? Set it down! We win! We'll be able to get off the highway, keep everybody safe. Oh, let's do that! Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo. Nice job!
I think George did a really great job today. He certainly picks up things quick, and he can tolerate me barking orders at him.
Eric, he said, I'm gonna let you run free. It's yours to screw it up, or it's yours to make it happen, and I made it happen.
You just jump in with both feet. You gotta have that mentality to wanna do this job, or you just won't be any good at it.
It's open, driver. It's open.